And I reckon you should make the offer.
Well, all right. But only if you promise me that you'll give her a good chance at clearing her name. Otherwise, no deal.
Yeah, sure.
You'll have to wait until the morning.
Oh, isn't there someone else I
can... Look, one more day is not going to make any difference. Mrs. Davidson, wait here. Miss Forster's gone home for the day.
Oh, is it anything important?
White says she wants to see a psychiatrist. Although it could be just a trick to help her at her trial.
Well, as a matter of fact, Dr. Wiseman will be here this afternoon anyway.
What about Miss Forster? Surely you can't ignore all this. Ever since she's come here, she's done nothing but sip cups of tea. She's inefficient, and she hasn't locked the door to her office.
Well, I'll speak to her tomorrow. Oh, by the way, I've arranged for some of the women to have a barbecue this evening, weather permitting. I don't think a little relaxation will do them any harm at this stage.
But they've broken every rule in the book.
Miss Bennet, in case you haven't noticed, there's a lot of ill feeling at the moment. I'm trying to avoid a situation getting completely out of hand.
Yes. I suppose you can't really afford any more trouble with the department.
Thank you for your support, Miss Bennet.
In. Brian, to see you, Mrs. Davidson. Stand there, Brian.
The women took a vote on who should speak to you on their behalf. I won.
Oh, they usually leave that to Smith.
Oh, yeah, well, they probably thought you'd only listen to someone who wasn't on the work duty when it got stopped.
All right, I'm listening.
Well, we've been chewing over what you'd said to us, and we think we probably were a bit hasty in blaming Kay. You know, it's just hard for them to face the facts, I guess. They're thinking they blew it themselves.
Yes, go on.
Well, we were hoping that you might give us another chance to square things with Kay. You know, if that's all right, show that everything's okay. We hoped you might let her go along to the barbecue. Well, it's better than being stuck in isolation all day, isn't it? I ought to know that. I just came from there.
Oh, thank you, Bryant. I'll think about it.
Thank you.
Mr. Fletcher.
Wait outside, Bryant.
What do you think?
Well, I don't know. They could be genuine.
I'm just wondering why Smith couldn't tell me that herself.
She probably wouldn't like to admit that she made a mistake. And the other women look up to Brian.
They probably wouldn't harm her while the other officers are there. And it could be a good opportunity to see just how genuine they are.
Of course, I never did believe in them psychiatric blokes. Dore went to one once. Fat lot of good it did her. Spent 2 weeks in a funny farm. I reckon if you can't sort yourself out, well, who's gonna help you? What do you reckon, Mr. Fletcher?
What?
I mean, you had a problem once, remember? You couldn't stand the sight of blood. But he got over it all by himself.
Just get on with your work, will you, Birdsworth?
Lizzie, there'll be an extra one for tea. Have you got enough to go around?
Oh, plenty. Well, does that mean that Kay's going to be joining us?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, beaut, isn't it, Margaret?
Yeah.
Poor little mite. We got such a lot to make up to her for, haven't we, Margot?
I hope Mrs. Davidson knows what she's doing.
Well, she can't keep White in isolation forever.
Jude must have laid it on thick.
Which is what I'm going to do when I get my hands on that little mole.
You heard B. Nobody's to do nothing until she says.
Want to take a break for a while?
Yeah, thanks. I could use one.
Screws, they can never take our word for anything again.
Listen, all's gonna happen at the barbecue is that she's gonna be greeted like a long-lost sister. Anyone would think we was getting a visit from the Queen. We even had to make out we were putting down the red carpet.
Yeah, well, let's not go overboard. Just nice and friendly will do.
You all right, Dor?
I'm trying to sleep.
Oh, come on, love. You better put on something warm in case it turns cold.
I'm not going.
All right, Doreen, enough's enough. You are going to eat about a force down your throat.
I feel sick.
Listen, you stupid little idiot. I'm not having you starving and winding up with a tube in your arm.
Yeah, Bee's right, you know. Anyway, what's wrong with a few pounds, eh?
You don't want to end up looking like a scarecrow like me, do?
Look, it's not putting on a few pounds that's worrying me. I'm bloody scared to death because I'm pregnant.
Then why are you looking as if your throat's been cut?
Oh, that's fantastic, honey.
Oh, you're gonna be a mother.
Oh, why don't you tell us, for God's sake? Everyone gets morning sickness.
Yeah, and that doesn't last long. One more reason why you have to keep up your strength.
Hey, that day out with Kev sure did the trick.
But no, it's not Kevin's. Can't be. It isn't his. I'm sure. I've been pregnant before. I know what it's like. I've checked the dates. And it can't be Kevin's. It's got to be that Vince Talbot creeps.
That bastard. Wish I'd kill him when I had the chance.
Yeah. What am I going to do? Kevin and me want to have our own kids. How can I tell him I've got someone else's inside of me?
The rotten mongrel. It's not your fault, love. He forced you into it. Nobody's gonna blame you.
If only he'd said something the first time he tried it.
How could I? He would have stopped the work release and none of you were around to help me.
Judy was there.
Not in the storeroom, she wasn't. Not when he... Oh, I was too scared.
Okay, there's no point going over all that. It's too late now.
Yeah, well, I know what I'd like to do to him. Just 1 minute alone with that guy, that's all I'd need.
Yeah, we're not going to get that chance now, though, are we? Thanks to your friend, Kay White.
Now, why blame Kay? It's Vince Talbot we should be tearing to pieces.
We could report him. We could get him stuck into jail.
Oh, sure. They're going to listen to a pack of criminals, aren't they? The same way that they listened to us telling them who killed Sharon.
I don't want anyone else to know. Please, Bee.
I promise you this much, Doreen. No man is going to get away with what he did to you. I don't know how, or when, or where. But he is going to pay.
What good does it do to go into my background? I've already told you, I come from a boring middle-class family with not so much as a parking ticket between the lot of them. It's now we ought to be talking about. Look, do you think I would have taken that money back if I was a criminal?
I take it you saw it as a loan.
I had a winner. I knew it. I could feel it. You don't turn your back on that sort of feeling.
What would have happened if it hadn't won?
I just told you. I knew it was a winner.
Yes, but you were juggling the books at the factory for some time prior to that. Didn't you see that as a crime?
No, I never intended keeping the money. Look, all I needed was one good win. I was close. I could feel it. Just one to come home at, say, 20-1 with 5,000 riding on it. I'd have had it made.
In what way? Wealth or pay back your gambling debts?
I'd have won.
Is there a history of gambling in your family?
No. My father was a bank manager. You know how tight they are with money. The biggest bet he ever had was 50 cents each way on the Melbourne Cup.
Do you think he was overly careful with his money?
No. They were always giving me presents, especially if I did well at school. And I did. The more successful I was, the more they boasted.
Well, wasn't that a worry to you? You know, trying to live up to a certain standard?
Of course not. I loved it. The best at everything. There's no feeling quite like it.
You must have had a lot of friends.
People looked up to me.